Both teams are lining up for the kickoff, and we're just about set to get this one underway. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Notre Dame's offense really centered around this quarterback, and as he goes, the team seems to go, Kirk.
Brett, over the weeks, I've been watching him on film, and one thing I've seen is his ability to make good decisions. I mean, time after time, he just avoids the mistakes. And when you can do that as a quarterback and as a leader of an offense, you're going to move the football down the field.
He's taken down at the 28-yard line. A couple, maybe 3 yards on that run. The play clock's at zero. They took too much time.
Delay of game. Offense.
That penalty will move them back a bit.
Yeah, with so many young guys out there, it's bound to happen occasionally.
From their own 23-yard line, second down.
Down. Blue 7. QQ. Yellow 7.
Gets it out, and he's met immediately. Drop back 4 yards on that one.
This defense is fast enough that they can create negative yards on completed passes. So the offense might want to consider that next time they try that play.
They come out in a 5-wide set. And they got him.
The defenders played the snap count perfectly. Found the pass into the backfield and didn't let the quarterback get away.
So no luck on that drive as they go three and out. The sack makes this a fourth and very long. He puts it away, and it's a great kick. And he makes it out to about the 44-yard line. Like a couple of boxers in round one, these two teams are feeling each other out.
Well, they had their opportunities here to make some plays to try to quiet this crowd, but they weren't able to do it. If things keep going this way, this stadium is going to get even louder.
He scrambled. Brought down at the 48-yard line. So the quarterback scrambles for about 4 yards on the play. Here's an opening. He's at the 40. Gains his way to the 36-yard line.
Some guys are dangerous no matter where they are on the field. Whether they have speed, elusiveness, great vision, whatever the case may be, you have to find ways to get the ball in their hands.
Fires it out. And down he goes, around the 30-yard line. And he's tackled at the 35-yard line.
Loss of 5 yards on the play. That'll make it good.
Third down now, and they need to get it to the 26. Fires that quickly, incomplete.
Number 10 was the intended receiver on the play. Fourth down.
Ohio State is looking to go up by 3. The kick is up. It's got the distance. And it's good. Like they're ready for the kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Buckeyes really took care of business on defense that first time out, perfect.
One of the great traditions of college football is this defense and the way they play with such passion and enthusiasm in this environment. We're seeing that again today.
And while they are behind, they know they can knock things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. Runs outside for a nice gain. Makes the catch and look out.
A quarterback's best friend is a receiver he can count on to catch the ball every time he drops back to pass.
Catches it and hit immediately for a loss. From their own 33-yard line, it's second down. Becoming the 12th man, the crowd is always into it here. Caught with room to work. And they push him out at the 43.
This guy is one of the most reliable receivers around. They needed a big play on third down, and he got it for them.
And a quick throw. And they make the stop at about the 37-yard line.
That'll make it second and four.
Oh, it almost picked off.
Boy, Brad, this guy drops an interception. And what's ironic about that from going to the meetings the other day is that this guy's been telling the coaches he wants to play some wide receiver. You wonder why you're not playing wide receiver? Because you can't catch the ball as a defensive back.
And he's level at the 43-yard line. He doesn't want a touchback here. He wants to knock this ball inside the 10. Booming kick. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. So they're just about set to get the game going again. Ohio State holds a field goal lead. Bring him down at the 28.
That's good for him. That makes it second and two.
Check 59. Mike is 59.
The thing I love about this guy is he can throw the ball, he can run it, and that's hard to stop.
Taken down at about the 47-yard line.
You love having this kind of weapon. You already know what kind of damage he can cause in the passing game. And here you can see what he can do when you hand the ball off to him.
He steps out right around midfield. Down, and they need to get it inside the 43. Now he's scrambling. He's tackled at the 47-yard line. He got 3 yards there on the scramble.
makes it fourth and four.
After a quarter of play, we've got a low-scoring defensive battle on our hands. Ohio State's got a three-point lead. Back to the action now here in the second quarter. Doesn't want to let the punt returner have a chance here. He just wants to change field position. It's away, and it's a booming punt. So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. This defensive end is having a very good day.
Well, Brad, I think he has all the intangibles that you ever want to see in a defensive end. I mean, he's got all the football smarts you could ask for, great work ethic, a motor that never stops. There's no wonder that he's a dominant player. I'm going to slide my offensive line and my protection towards him to be able to try to take him away and do anything to try to mix up my looks for him.
There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Hands it off, and they get him in the backfield for a loss. They bring him down.
The smart quarterbacks and offensive linemen have a really unique relationship. A quarterback should take care of his offensive linemen. But after that play and that hit, you really got to be wondering what kind of relationship this quarterback and his offensive lineman have after that.
Third and long now after the sack. The intimidation factor is definitely here when you're playing in this stadium. And he is drilled at the three.
Well, we talked all week with these coaches, and even when we met with them yesterday out in practice, they told us there were some big concerns about facing these defensive ends. They thought that they might be able to hold up against him, maybe get the ball out of the pocket a little bit quicker, maybe use running backs and tight ends to help with double teams on the outside. But right now, whatever they thought they might be able to do, they better get back to that drawing board because these defensive ends are just too quick.
And that'll be three and out. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. He gets out to about the 38-yard line. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Ohio State is up by three. Throws it in a hurry. Tackle made at about the 35.
Number 21 makes the tackle at the 35-yard line. That'll make it second and seven.
Chance. Tackle at the 20.
First down here, Brad, by this offense. The receiver's running the football. You got to think, as a defensive coordinator, it's one thing to try to defend it, kind of your traditional offensive attack, but here you got to start worrying about what is this wide receiver going to do. It puts a lot of pressure on the defense and the defensive mindset on how they want to try to slow this offense down.
He's on the run, runs with it, and he's got room. He's taken down around the 7-yard line. Touchdown, Buckeyes.
Can get pretty fierce in this territory, but they look totally in control there.
And he tacks on the extra point. So that's a 5-play, 38-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Boy, this offense right now is just being physical, really controlling the line of scrimmage, and it's opening up some nice big lanes for the running back.
Looks like they're ready for the kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. The quarterback in the gun. Empty backfield. Five wide receivers in the formation. Got a man. Watch out here. Out of bounds at the 29-yard line.
Call it a gain of 4 yards. That makes it 2nd and 6.
They'll spread the field with five wide. Steps out of bounds at the 33.
Mike five.
The crowd really making it difficult. Caught and out of bounds after a short gain.
Call it a gain of 5 yards. First down.
Roger. They'll line up with five wide receivers.
Watch a slant.
Gets it out to him again. He's pushed out of bounds at the 49.
Gain of 13 on the play.
Pick it up.
That makes it 1st and 10.
Mike.
Boy, just when it looked like they had a chance to get right back into this game, they throw the interception. Now, it's still early. Let's see if their defense can bail them out.
It's 1st and 10. Ball on the 7. Catches it, and he's immediately tackled behind the line. Loss of a yard.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
6-yard line. That'll bring up 2nd and 11.
Throws a bullet over the middle. Brought down at the 12. Forced to punt it away here.
On 3rd down, the defense was expecting the pass, and they defended the play very well in the secondary.
Oh, excellent punt. And he's tackled at the 43. We'll have to see now how the offense responds this time after throwing a pick on their last drive.
The game is in danger of getting out of hand early. It's very, very important that they not only hang on to the football this drive, but they also need to get a score on the board as well.
Get to that quickly. The quarterback was just lucky to get that pass off. He was under a lot of pressure in the pocket.
He took what the defense gave him that time, which is okay. It keeps the yards to go a little bit more manageable.
Down he goes, around the 41-yard line.
First down. Mike five.
There's a strike complete. He's down.
That's a gain of 4 on the play. That makes it 2nd and 6.
Mike five.
Makes the catch, and he's got nowhere to go. They can't hear a thing down there.
This quarterback is tough as nails, Brad. He's going to sit in that pocket and give himself a chance. The only problem is, at some point, you've got to have a feel, almost that sixth sense on when to get out of there and avoid the pressure or just to throw the ball before you get hit.
The kick is away. It's long enough, and he splits the uprights. Notre Dame kicked this one off. excellent kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Both offenses have played it pretty close to the best so far in this one.
Yeah, because they've been so conservative, it's made it pretty easy for both of these defenses to be pretty dominant. Let's see an offense open it up and take a few chances.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. And he's tackled at the 30. The Buckeyes taking their first time out of the half. We've got a second and five. Ball on their own 30. So an empty backfield with five wide receivers. He's going to try and scramble. And they bring him down for a sack on the play.
Absolutely perfect call by the defensive coordinator. He brought just the right amount of pressure from the right direction, and it seemed to confuse the offense.
Big opening. And they're not going to get it. Great stop.
You know, the offense dug themselves such a big hole on this series that they come up short here on third down. This is a nice run on third down and long. The problem is they have so far to go to pick up a first down that they bring up the fourth down then.
Tackle at the 30-yard line.
Can this defense play any better? I mean, these guys have a great tradition. They live up to the billing today. Now we're starting to see whether or not this team can get it done. And if they are, then I think the defense should go down to the offensive side of the field, talk to their own offense, and try to get them fired up to go out there and get some more points on the board.
10-19.
He's in trouble. Quick shot to the tight end, and he can't pull it in.
That is textbook pass defense. As soon as the ball hit the receiver's hands, he was all over.
From their own 30-yard line, second down. There's a strike complete, and they make the stop
at about the 43-yard line.
That's a gain of 13 on the play. First down.
Pick and he dropped it.
Hey, that's a heads up play there by the defender. Get those hands up and something good may just happen.
Second and 10. Ball on the 43.
There. Motion, motion, motion. Black nine.
Fires out quickly to the tailback. They'll bring him down at the 43-yard line.
Number one with the tackle at the 43-yard line. That makes it first and 10.
Down. Kill, kill. Yellow 7.
Picked off. It's the cornerback. Great first half comes to a close. The Buckeyes with a touchdown lead.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollock here, completely locked in on that first half. It's usually just something that a coach writes on the board. No big plays.
No.
But typically when you have offenses like these, you get a few big plays. What do you think the defense has done so well in terms of taking away those long plays?
Well, that's always your goal coming into a game, is you want the offense to drive the length of the field and make them put together third down, you know, explosive, or make them put together third downs and make them get short yardage. Really just, you're okay with them eating up the clock and just not getting explosive plays and big long touchdowns. And that's your goal. How do you do it? You got to just limit the damage. Sometimes you're going to give up that 10-yard play. You make a tackle, you wrap it up, you get back in the huddle. Sometimes you're going to give up a big run. Wrap them up. Don't let them score a touchdown. So you always want to make an offense drive the length of the field and earn everything they get. And so far in the first half, that's what they've done.
That'll do it here in the studio at halftime. We'll try to see if Pollock can bring a little energy in the second half. Got a lot of games to watch, including yours. Brad and Kirk, ready for the second half.
All right.
right, Reese and David, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start here.
Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. And here we go with the offense ready to get things going again. Ohio State is up 7. And he makes it out to about the 27-yard line.
That's a gain of 2 on the play.
Let's go.
That makes it 7-8.
Fires quickly, and he's got his man. And he's taken down around the 33-yard line.
Gain of 6 on the play. Third down.
Fires it out. And he hits him hard at the 49-yard line. So the sack makes this a second and long.
Check 59. Mike is 59. Mike the 59.
You can't block me.
Just throws this one away.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. And they push him out at the 45.
That makes it 4th and 4.
They're trying to pin them deep with a solid punt right here. He punts it away, and it's a great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Tackled after a decent run up the gut.
Gaining 4 yards. That makes it 2nd and 6.
Three down.
And he throws it away. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
Third down, 6 to go. Ball on the 24. Becoming the 12th man, the crowd is always into it here. He gets rid of this one.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
Got stood up right there. Their last drive broke down and they punted. What do they have in store this time out? Ohio State up 7 points. The halfback with a carry. He gets hit out of bounds at the 45-yard line.
That'll bring up 2nd and 3.
He's tackled at the 42.
You keep gaining negative yards, and you put yourself in a position of having to make bigger and bigger plays. Puts a lot of pressure on that quarterback.
From their own 42-yard line, third down.
Hey, alert 48. Hey, we're going to mic the there.
Now he's scrambling. At the 40. He's at the 30. And he's out of bounds at the 22-yard line.
Down.
he'll keep it on the ground again. Gets out to about the 21. Once again, they'll come to the line trying to convert on third down.
Check 59. Mike is 59. Mike is 59.
Down. 3-8.
Boy, was he drilled as he let go of that football.
Yeah, he's going to feel that one tomorrow.
That'll bring up fourth and nine.
Ohio State is hoping to make this a two-score game. It's up. And it sails through the uprights. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Ohio State's continuing to play extremely tough defense. This has been impressive.
It's just been impressive to watch them play with such an attitude, almost a chip on their shoulder with the energy that they're playing with. I think it's going to require that kind of effort to be able to win this game.
The offense is looking to be a little bit more successful with this drive as they had to punt the ball away the last time they had it.
Down two possessions. This offense has to step up and capitalize on this possession.
Now he tries to buy some time. He's wrapped up for the sack.
I think that one's on the offensive line. They've got to do a better job of holding their blocks, or else this quarterback's going to be pulling turf out of his face mask all game.
So it'll be second and 14 after the setback.
Crunch time, defense.
On the run and it's picked off.
Really nice cover skill shown here this time. That's exactly what you want to see from your young corners.
They can't hang with us. Check 59. Mike is 59. Mike the 59.
Sit up. Flight 87.
Tackle made at the 46-yard line. The 47-yard line. So they wrapped him up before he could get anything going.
Yeah, there was nothing there on that option. That'll bring up
third down, and they need to get it down to the 39.
34, eyes on 34.
Tighten up.
Flight 87.
They'll make the sack.
Coaches don't like it when their quarterback gets hit like that. Don't be surprised to see the old coach get on his lineman to protect the quarterback a little bit better.
He really got a hold of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Yeah, it's been kind of a nightmare for this offensive line.
This defense has been bringing the blitz and is having success getting to him. If it wasn't for the solid efforts of this defense, they might not have a two-possession lead. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. Tackle at the 28.
Gain of 8 on the play. That makes it second and 2.
Mike 5.
They'll wrestle him down in the backfield.
That's not what you hope for from your running game. You're looking for some solid north and south progress. You never want to give the defense a play like that to build their confidence.
Third down and 7. ball on their own 23. They're one of the loudest crowds in the country, and they are on their feet. Quick pass.
I like the call here by the defense to bring the heat with the outside linebacker. It was just a better call by the offense, and that's why it's a first down.
Makes it out to about the 49.
That's a gain of 12 on the play.
Mike five.
First down.
Larry, Larry, Larry. Watch two, watch
get
two.
Up. Blue, seven.
Fires complete over the middle. Brought down at the 40.
Number two, with the touchdown. The 49
Mike five, Mike
first
five.
Down.
And the offense picks it up, and down he goes at about the 31. And this is still anyone's ball game as we head into the final quarter of play. Ohio State's got a 10-point lead. Back in this very pivotal fourth quarter.
All you get is a headache. All you get is a headache. Mike five. Mike five.
And he makes it out to about the 31-yard line. And this crowd is going absolutely crazy. Just throws this one away. It's fourth down, and they're going to try to go for it. They'll drop it for a loss. And they'll fail on fourth down.
And the defense looked like they were expecting option on that play. Great job to pin them up and cause the turnover on downs.
Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. Quick throw. He's knocked out of bounds. Right around the 40. Run to the left there. He fights forward to about the 49.
That's a gain of 3 on the play. That'll make it 2nd and 7.
He's into the open field. He takes it right side for a good game.
Gain of 4 on the play. That makes it 3rd and 3.
Mike, Mike is 59.
And they'll get him in the backfield.
Great job here in shutting down the run. That's a real boost for this team.
Away and it's a booming punt. So this one goes into the end zone and that'll be a touchback. It's been a tough outing for this quarterback, Irby.
Right now the defensive pressure flat out is causing these turnovers. When you're a defensive coordinator, you want to always try to get your defense to pin their ears back and put pressure on the quarterback. When you do that, you're going to create opportunities.
He hasn't done much to silence the fans, but let's see if he can put something together here. A fumble ended this offense's last drive. Let's see as they come out on the field what they'll do this time around.
I look for the offense to come out with the same game plan as before. You don't make changes after one play.
Swings it out there incomplete. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 20. They come out in a 5-wide set. Quickly incomplete. The crowd really making it difficult.
Anytime you can put the quarterback on the ground, or in this case, bat the ball at the line of scrimmage, you're letting your presence be felt. Believe me, that quarterback is aware of the play of the defensive front.
Booming kick. He's at midfield. Tackle at the 48. Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. And he's tackled around the 31-yard line. From the 31-yard line, it's first down. Less than 3 minutes in the game. He gets out to about the 21-yard line. That'll make it second and inches.
Here we go, Hey, watch
Notre Dame will take a timeout. That's their first of the half. They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down.
Mike is 59. Mike is 59.
Line 87. Line 87.
He's tackled in the open field. So on third down, they come away with a first down on the option play.
Third and short, and the defense almost had him stopped. But the offense got just enough to move the chains.
He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line. And he gets a yard on the run. Second and nine coming up here. Ball on the 20-yard line. And they make the stop at the 10. Touchdown, Buckeyes. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Ohio State is ready to kick it away. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Notre Dame's coaches have got to be scratching their heads right now. They know they have to go back to work and go back to work in a hurry.
Well, the coaches are going to want to go back to work, and the players are not going to want to show up in the film room. They're going to be hiding after this performance. This was embarrassing.
Just over a minute left. They'll bring him down around the 32-yard line.
Number 12 brings him down at the 32-yard line.
And he stops the clock with a spike. Third down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Really one of the very tough places to play in college football, and it's no different today.
This quarterback is tough as nails, Brad. He's going to sit in that pocket and give himself a chance. The only problem is, at some point, you've got to have a feel, almost that sixth sense on when to get out of there and avoid the pressure, or just to throw the ball before you get hit.
Oh, excellent punt. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. So it's time to see this offense go to work again.
This defense couldn't stop them from moving the ball and inevitably finding the end zone.
We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock.
Double tight.
Notre Dame staff and really this entire team, I'm sure, is going to rally around this kid.
Yeah, it's a tough loss for this team. I mean, they put so much into this game. But one thing about them is they're a team. And even though their star player had a tough game, I think they'll pick him back up and get him ready to go by next week.
That's it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you soon.